I want to thank God for your life. I want to welcome everybody to this service this morning. We'll continue and when we stop, enlarge my territory. This is part three. Enlarge my territory. This is part three. We gave the definition of enlargement, make or become bigger or more extensive. We want God to make us spiritually bigger, to commit more assignments into our hands. We are praying that the Almighty God will enlarge the course of our ministries. That the Almighty God will give us more opportunities to preach the gospel.
Amen.
Also to bless us physically. That's what we're asking God to do. And territory means an area which one has certain rights. An area within your domain, your destiny. A particular area where you have responsibility with regards to a particular activities where you have responsibility to lead your destiny. That is what we mean by territory. And I pray God Almighty to enlarge your territory in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And last week we were able to give preambles to what we mean by wanting God to enlarge our territory. I don't want to go into that. But before I proceed to look into the life of Jabez, as we had in the main text that we're using for this message, I want to give us some facts about life. I can say enlarge my territory, that God will enlarge your territory. I can say anything that I want to say, but most importantly, you have a part to play. Your destiny is in your hands. Your future is in the hands of God. But as you continue to plan and as you continue to live your life, God wants you to have parts to play in the implementation of your destiny. Your destiny will not be sold in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to say very carefully to all of us, we must not allow whatever names the enemy may call us to make us lose focus as to achieving our destiny in life. No matter what anybody is calling you, no matter the names that devil is giving, no matter any words that devil is trying to reach out to you to discourage you, you must not allow that to dictate how you live your life. I listened after this name calling by the government or the president of this country, I listened to comments all over. There are programs, people, in fact, a lady, an African lady, I think precisely a Nigerian, was talking from Europe, and she was saying, it's like saying all these things they are talking is making me feeling ashamed, I'm just very ashamed, I'm not happy. I want to tell all of us, it is your responsibility to make yourself happy.
Yes.
You should not allow whatever names anybody may call you to make you sad. Amen?
Amen.
There is nothing new under heaven. I put some 7 facts down that I want to discuss with you before we go to the issue of Jabez. No one is doing anything anybody has never done in history. Nobody is doing anything anybody has never done. And anything that happens to man, anything that happens to a nation, anything that happens to a continent is seasonal. Nothing is permanent. It's seasonal. I want you to read history. I want you to read the Bible. There is nothing anyone is doing. Either somebody is migrating from one country to the other, migrating from one state to another state, migrating from one continent to another, that is new. In fact, it is normal. Now, I just want to tell you again, do not allow anything somebody is telling you, whatever Satan is saying, whatever somebody is calling you, calling your family, calling your husband, calling your wife, or calling your children, do not allow that to dictate how you live your life. As a matter of fact, you see me, I'm so happy, I'm so proud. I thank God for where God allowed me to come through to this life. I thank God for Nigeria. I came from Nigeria. I thank God for my parents. The first thing I want to tell you is this. You do not dictate, you do not control where you will be born. You do not dictate, you do not have right to say, God, I want you to help me to come through so person. We do not have that right. We don't know. God, the best place God wants you to come
to this life truth is when you came to this life truth. God designed your parents to be your parents. God designed the country where you came from to be your country. Why are you not blaming yourself to be the race that you are? Why are you blaming yourself to be the gender that you are? You don't control to be a man, you don't control to be a woman. Why should I be blaming you? There are countries where they kill ladies, girls. They will just kill them because they want more boys. They kill girls. Can you imagine that kind of wickedness? There are things in life we do not control. I put it, there's no human being that decides where, when, and how he or she will be born. No human being. You don't choose your country or of birth. You do not choose it. Amen?
Amen.
Your parents can choose that for you. They can choose that for you, but you don't choose it. If your parents like it, if they want it, when you are conceived, they may make effort to travel out of the United States and go to somewhere in Europe to go and give birth to you. You cannot be telling your parents when they are taking that decision, talking from the womb. Mommy, no. I don't want to go there, stay here. If that happens, your mommy will jump up and she'll be crying, say, I have not seen this before. She'll be looking for doctor to doctor, looking for counselor that this baby is talking, is telling me what to do. So now, why should we be blaming ourselves or complaining or somebody? Anybody can talk anything. You can talk anything. That shouldn't make you sad. That should make you feel ashamed. It should make you feel proud. Amen? You should be proud that you are the race that God has helped you to be. And God can enlarge you through that. God can bless you through that. God can, in fact, make you to become a blessing unto others through that. The second thing is this. Anyone can form any opinion about anybody. You can sit down in your room and form any opinion. Now, that is the problem of that person. You should not now, because of that opinion that person has formed, now live your life through that. No, you should not. You should not. As you see in the life of Jabez. Jabez was named Jabez because he was a grief, born in pain. But he decided that I'm going to shake this one. I'm not going to allow this name that was given to me to be my destiny. I must go to God who can do it. Look at what Shakespeare said. William Shakespeare said, destiny is the one who deals the deck, but we are the ones who play the cards. You are the one who plays the cards. If I buy you a car, and I say, this is your car, what do you think is going to happen? Do you still want me to be driving the car since I bought you the car? It is your responsibility to do what? To drive the car and enjoy the car. Whatever destiny will bring your way, it is your responsibility to implement and to enjoy whatever destiny will bring your way. Amen. And God has a good thought for you. It's a thought of peace and not of evil. To give you hope, to give you a bright future. Tell somebody your future is bright.
Your future is bright.
Your destiny is in your hands. As a matter of fact, I know our future is in the hands of God, but also it's in your hands. If you allow,
this is what they're calling me. They say I'm from Ghana.
The person who is calling me that name is enjoying. The person who is calling that name is very happy, is dominant, and you are. That is what Satan wants. When you are going to tell Satan, I'm not going to live that life. The Bible says, the heart is the Lord and the fullness thereof. Anywhere the sole of your feet will tread, the Lord will give unto you.
Amen.
Nobody is a stranger. All of us were immigrants in this world. Heaven is our home. That's our country. So, if somebody is calling you stranger in any land, it is a seasonal stranger. It is a seasonal what? Seasonal classification. The permanent classification is to get yourself secured to get to heaven. If you don't secure yourself on that,
that's where we have the problem. The fourth one is this.
Our future can only be nurtured, prepared, taken care of. Yes, with the help of God, as a Christian, we live by faith in God. So, our future, it is you. If you plant a seed, it is you that will take care of all the weeds. To ensure that that seed, the weeds will not hit all the nutrients that that seed will need to bring a bountiful harvest. It is your responsibility to do that. And those of us that have been in the farm, you know what it means when you are in a farm and you are a farmer? You don't just cut the weeds on the top. You do what? You uproot it. That is the best thing. You uproot the weeds. So any weeds, either opinion of somebody, either name calling of somebody, they are all weeds to shock the seed of our destiny so that we don't have a good food. What do? You put your hand there, you do what? You uproot it. You take it out so that the seed of your destiny will be able to grow and have enough strength, enough nutrient, so that by the time you are doing the harvesting, you're going to have a bountiful harvest. The next one. You have the responsibility to guide your life, your journey, to take a part of your destiny. No one else will do that for you. In this land that we find ourselves, it is your responsibility to guide your journey. Guide your journey very well, my brother. My sister, guide your journey. Ensure that you go to where God wants you to go. Relate with people that are positive. Don't listen to just all the advices. In fact, if somebody is advising you, it is your responsibility to peruse all those advices, to think deep over all these advices, and take a decision that you know will benefit you. If you love yourself, you don't just say, "Oh, he advised me, he told me to quit," and you just quit. No! It is your responsibility to listen to that advice, but take the advice based on your understanding that this is going to be a positive intervention in my destiny. It's your responsibility. Some people, they live a life of blame. Blame everything. They will blame God. They will blame their father. They will blame their mother. They will blame their wife. They will blame their husband. Anybody around them, they will be blaming this person. Look at James. James was not blaming his mother. He didn't say, "Mommy, why should you do this to me? You know, names are prophetic. Why should you call me James? Why do you think, even if you give back to me in pain, why should you call me that name? Why do you, mommy?" No! He went to God and he told God, "I want you to bless me indeed. I want you to change this name. I want you to change this future. I want a blessed future. I want you to enlighten my cause." He began to table his request to God. Nothing should be an impediment to achieving our purpose and living our destiny. Nothing whatsoever should be an obstacle or impediment to live your destiny. Nothing. And those of us that are in this country, that were not born in this country, there is no obstacle that will stop us from becoming great here. Any opportunity I got, I will use here. If I want on my own to go to any other place, I will go. But not you that will dictate it. No matter what we are saying, we're going to eat the cake together.
Amen.
Tell somebody amen.
Amen.
No matter, you like talk whatever, we're going to do what?
Eat the cake together.
We're going to shop your dollar together. Amen. That's not going to make me sad. I will tell you history. I want you to read history. Read history. Let me get a little bit of this. Let me first start. I want to see, read history about the movement of various people or various countries to the United States or to North America. Read it. Let me tell you the word of Germans. The Germans began to move to this country en masse in about 1600, about 1640, when they were having the issue of plantation. The history that I read said
that the first major wave of German immigration occurred. The first major wave, they were moving in the 16 something, they were moving, but the major wave occurred in the 1840s. When German, like many other European countries, suffer from serious crop failures. They got potato problems, like the Irish. When they got these potato problems, like the Irish, people were dying. We are told that from like a population of 8 million to 6 million Irish, some died, some migrated because of the problem in potato plantation. Potato plantation. Do you know that it is normal to human beings? When you are in a place and there is a chalet, there is a problem, to look for a better life. It is normal. Come on, brother. But sister, it's very normal. Now, people tend to gravitate towards where there will be greener pasture. People tend to gravitate to that. And it is seasonal. And it affects every race in the world. Look at what is happening in Africa now. The Chinese are moving to Africa. In fact, if Nigeria is not careful, the Chinese will colonize Nigeria again. Chinese, they are moving like they want to do everything for African country. They want to do the train system. They want to do Chinese. Read the news. See how they are moving. Chinese, they are moving. What about the Indians? Indians. I'm not talking of the native Indians here. I'm talking of the Asia, the Indians, the real Indians. They're moving. They want to take over everything. They're talking to the government of all these African nations. And we are told also that another wave of immigration of these Germans was during the time, in fact, not only Germans, many European countries, during the time of industrialization of America. In the late 1800s, people were coming to work in the coal mines, were coming to work in the train system, they were coming to work in all these industrialized setup, the machine, they were all moving. The Irish were moving, the Germans were moving. In fact, they were all struggling. The major, the Spain, the French, the British, they were all trying to, this one is trying to take over, this one trying to be in power, to be more prominent in this country. Amen. Amen. So our destiny, your destiny is in your hands.
Amen.
And now, human beings, we are tend to kind of say, I'm here first. And then I must initiate you, or you must listen to me. We tend to do that. My brothers and my sisters, the Lord is sent to enlarge your coast.
Amen.
Do not let anything be an obstacle for you to achieve that.
Amen.
Do not allow anything whatsoever to discourage you. Amen. Devil will like to discourage you. Satan will like to stop you. But you on your own, you have to have the determination that no one will stop me.
Amen.
That no one whatsoever will place an impediment on my path as to achieving my destiny in any land God has placed me. Nothing is by accident. If you have given your life to Jesus Christ, nothing is by accident. Your being in this country at this time is never an accident. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't need a prophet to tell you that. If God does not want you to be here, if God does not want you to have the blessing you have, if God does not want you to have the business you find yourself, or the profession you find yourself, God has a way to stop you. He has a way to stop you. And so wherever you are finding yourself, wherever you may be, I can tell you as a Christian, that is where God wants to be at that time. And then seize the opportunity. And God can bless you anyhow. Greater is a small beginning if God is in it. You may start very small. It may look like you are the poorest person. But God can still bless you. Let me tell you a little bit of the Irish people. I will tell you a little bit of these Irish people. We are told that the Irish people, this is so pathetic. Between 7 and 20 years, some Irish people were sold into slavery. From 1641 to 1652, over 300,000 Irish people were sold as virtual slaves.
as a form of punishment to the first 13 colonies lasting between 7 to 20 years. They were sold in, I mean, can you understand doing this for themselves? And that's why you see some of these high people, most of them move en masse to the United States. And you see them all over in many tricks, in many sector of this country. And then in 1845 to 1849, there's this one time, go ahead, you can look, this thing I'm telling you is facts. They are all online. You can Google all these things. Google European immigration to the United States or to North America. You read all this thing I'm telling you. Between 1845 to 1849, there was what they call Irish potato famine in the land. It was a great famine and people were dying. We are told that people were dying because of lack of food, of this potato problem, and then they begin to move out looking for a better place, and most of them moved to the United States to stay. And then when there was this industrialization of America, in railroads, in steam power, and many of them gained employment opportunity, and they begin to move into this country. Virtually, I want to thank God for the way God made things to work for human beings. Human beings tend to move from places to places. Even those who classify races, sometimes it's hard to classify some races. Some people, you look at them, you don't even know either they are white or green or blue or black. Everybody mixed together. Are you going to talk of the Mexicans? In fact, in San Antonio, the history that I read said that there was a time that the Mexicans that occupied San Antonio, you know, San Antonio was owned by Mexicans in the past, right? For the war. They said they moved because of the problem and the devastation of the economy. They ran away from San Antonio. Mexicans, they ran away. And I look at that place today, if they want to get to that place today, they're going to get a visa, they're going to do everything. Some of these San Antonio, San Jose, some part of California, were owned by the Mexicans. This is what I'm saying. Your destiny is in your hands. Devil would like to distort you. Would like to distort your future. Devil would like to stop you. But you got to tell devil, I am unstoppable. Amen. That God is going to enlarge my course. You got to tell devil, this life, this one life I have, I will be successful.
Amen.
There will be nothing that will cause an obstacle or impediment for me to live a successful life based on the purpose of God for my life. I am not going to withdraw because of what somebody is saying. I will determine in my heart that forward ever, backward never.
Amen.
It takes you to determine that. Do not look down on yourself. Everybody can look down on you, but when you look down on yourself, it is a jeopardy. It is far double one. It is titanic. You don't look down on yourself. I'm very proud. Look, I don't hide it. People ask me, oh, your asset, where are you from? With all this year I spent here, they can see no my asset. I try to call it, as they call it, God, heart. They see, know that I am originally from Florida. And I tell you the truth, I'm very proud. I am very proud because sometimes when I demonstrate the knowledge that God has given me as an engineer, I'm proud of that. I'm proud of that. God has given all of us level of intelligence. It has nothing to do with your this, your this. No, it's opportunity. It's done with five, you know, white folks. Stand with them. Beat them down. Honestly speaking, I don't want to talk too much. Oh, this guy is, this pastor is trying to, you know, praise himself. I'm thanking God. I'm thanking him where I was born. I'm thanking for the opportunity I got to be in that place, to come out of that place. I'm thanking God for my parents. I am telling you, in the profession I find myself as an engineer, when I practice with these so-called folks, beat them and down, hands down. So, you are not alone. You will be forced to pronounce my name when you Adesanya, Adesanya, you will be forced to pronounce. It is when I need your service, when I need your service, what do you say? That's when I need your service. But when you need my service, you will listen. Because you need that service. Because I got to give that service to you. Because you need that help. Do not let somebody rule you how to talk this. This rubbish people are talking. Go and see statistics. See statistics of Africans, especially Nigerians. Most of Nigerians, they have master's degree, PhDs. The generation, the children that we have brought to this country, go and look at statistics. See, look at it. They are excelling.
Hallelujah.
In science, in arts, our children, they are beating the whole obstacles. Our children, I'm serious. In fact, it's been said in this country that most Nigerian parents, they place pressure on their children that you must survive, you must succeed.
Yes.
This man, you must do this, you must do that. And they say because of that pressure, some of them are breaking down.
Right.
But they can break down, they will not die.
Amen.
They must succeed.
Amen.
If I crawl, I want my children to run.
Amen.
If I'm running, I want them to fly.
Ah.
I want them to lose. Honestly speaking. And now, I am thinking it is out of jealousy.
Yes.
It is out of jealousy.
That's right.
Because when our people go anywhere, they will seize every opportunity. They are go-getters. They will work hard. Look, in any race, don't get me going this morning. In any case, there are bad apples. There are bad apples. And those bad apples should not define all of us.
Uh-huh.
Anywhere in the world, crime, the word crime, tell me any country, any race, that the word crime is not available in their system. Hello? Why do you have law? Is there any country without constitution?
No.
Excuse me? Is there any country without constitution?
No.
We have lawyers here. Why do you have constitution? Why do you have the commandments? To maintain peace. To help us. Because I suffer. Can you imagine, I have told you before, can you imagine if there are no traffic lights, no stop signs, all the roads, there are no demarcation, no line, nothing, they tell you, drive as light. No speed limit, speed as light. Well, praise the Lord. Can you imagine what's going to happen, the chaos that's going to happen? Can you imagine? So, because of little bit of bad eggs, you cannot use those bad apples to define God.
That's right.
I want you to be proud of your nation, wherever you are from. I may not know. Be proud of your family, where you are, where you came from. Be proud of who you are. Any profession you find yourself, go in and excel in that profession.
Amen.
Any profession you find yourself. If you are an engineer, be the best. If you are a lawyer, try to be the best. I get testimony coming in from our people. If you are an accountant, be what?
Be the best.
If you are a medical doctor, be the best. A news is flashing around now. A Nigerian doctor, a lady had a tumor and also pregnant. This Nigerian doctor from the so-called bad name they call him.
Chito.
Well, I don't want to call your daughter. This Nigerian doctor removed the fetus, the embryo, put it somewhere. Doctors, I don't know where they place it, maybe in the incubator. And then operated on this woman, removed the tumor. Then put back, it was doing that operation about 23 weeks of pregnancy. I'm saying it off hand, I read it. Okay. And then placed the baby back after the operation to the womb of the woman. And then that lady was able to carry that pregnancy to term and deliver the baby safely.
Woo!
Yeah. God has given to every human being. The Bible says we are all created in the image of God in God's likeness. Every human being created in the image of God, in the likeness of God, we have the intelligence, we have the know-how, we have the will. In the image of God, we have the emotion. God created all of us. The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your destiny is right there in your hands. Do not let whatever somebody is saying to define you. It's a fact that we never decide where, when, and how we are to be born. So you can don't blame me if I'm black. Go and do what? Go and blame God. He created me. Look, God decides that. You may come from rich or poor family. God decides that. You may even come from a very worse environment or country. God decides that. None of this should stop us from exerting life. Either you are from a poor home, that should stop you from becoming great. Either you are from a rich home, don't let that stop you too, because some people they are from rich home, that will stop them. I got money. My parents, they are very rich. Ah. Have you ever been to our house? When we drink with gold. Our cups, they are good. You have to work hard. So that will not become history.
Yes.
And because you are from a poor, very poor, that does not mean anything. You see, I'm very poor. In fact, my parents cannot send me to school. If God wants you to go to school, even if your parents will not be able to send you to school, God will make a way.
Oh, yes.
You just have to do like Jabez. Jabez was born in pain. The Bible recorded that Jabez went to God. I will read that and we are going to pray now. Chronicles chapter 4, verse 9 says, now Jabez was more honorable than his brothers. And his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bore him in pain. And Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, oh, that you will bless me indeed. This is my name. They look down on me because of this name. This is my name. Satan has stolen my destiny. This is the name they gave to me. It's not a good name, Lord. It's not, this name will not give me a good destiny. But God, if you can bless me indeed, and enlarge my territory, because I'm from this background, does not mean you cannot enlarge my territory. Help me, God. And your hand will be with me. Let your hand be with me. Don't have me at disadvantage. But God, let your hand be with me. I don't know your situation now. You may be at a disadvantage. Not because of the way you look, not because of your status, anything, but God can place his hand on you. And when God's hand is on you, you are unstoppable. God will make what is not sufficient to be over sufficient for you. God will make things that he will provide oasis in the desert of your life. As long as you allow, you pray that God's hand will be upon you. And he said, and that you will keep me from evil. There are evil in the land. That God will keep you from evil that can stop your destiny. That God will keep you from evil that can destroy your future. He can do it. He's a good God. He's a good God. And that I may not cause pain. Pain to people around me. That I may not cause pain. Pain to my friends. God, if you can do that. And of course, look at what happened. So God granted him what he requested.
Amen.
I don't know your situation. I don't know what you want God to do. But do you know what you have to do? Do like the best. Go to God in prayer. Table your situation. Table your needs before God. Tell him what you want him to do. Tell God the Almighty where he wants him to take you. Tell him to shape your destiny. And he will do it. He's a good God. He listen. And the question I'm going to ask you, after God will have done it, then what are you going to do? I'm very sure we are not told here that Jabez ran away from God. No, he did not. He stayed there. And that is where the verse of the year will come in. It says, Psalm 18 verse 36, you enlarged my path under me, so my feet did not slip. There is no doubt, if you can bring your situation to God, he will help you, he will enlarge your course, he will bless you, indeed. But after God will have done that, will you let your feet slip? Will you stay with God or will you run away? There are people in this this land. People in this land, that when they are seriously in need, they call on God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Jacob, and God bless them. And as soon as God bless them and they are comfortable, they will run away from God. Just not be that person in the mighty name of Jesus. After God will have blessed you, will you stay with God? After God will have enlarged your post, will you stay with God? Will you allow the blessings of God in your mind to expand His kingdom? Or what is your plan?
Psalm 37 verse 21 to 24, and we're going to pray. The Bible says, the wicked borrows and does not repay. The wicked. Psalm 37 verse 21. Maybe I will say, the wicked prayed that God will enlarge his or her post. And then after that, he did not pay God back. He ran away from God. Maybe I should say that in my own interpretation.
The wicked borrows and does not pay or repay. For the righteous shows mercy and gives. After God will have enlarged your post, will you show mercy to somebody? Will you show mercy to his kingdom? Will you work hard for the cause of the gospel? After God will have enlarged your post, after God will have blessed you, the anointing of God over your life, where are you going to use it? For those blessed by him shall inherit the earth. For those cursed by him shall be cut off. You will not be cursed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
After God will have blessed you, after God will have enlarged your coast, will you stand still? Will you let your feet stand in it? Will you bless somebody else? Will you reach out to someone else? Will you help somebody? Or are you going to look down on somebody and make death of somebody? Look at your friend. As you see your friend like that, it's empty. He has nothing at all. Are you going to do that? Or you want to reach out and pray for that person that is in need so that God can also bless you like he has blessed you or bless you as he has blessed you? Are you going to be a blessing unto others? Or you're going to be discouraged unto others? Are you going to encourage somebody? It's been said that some people, when they are forced in a place, they don't want others to come in.
Yes.
And when others are coming in, they will discourage them, tell them stories. They will not tell them the enjoyment part of it. But they will tell them, you know, everything is together. They will tell them the problem part of it, so they can discourage that person from not getting in there. But what are you going to gain from doing that? Are you going to tell somebody, if you work hard on someone to be fired in your office, are you going to take that person's salary plus your salary? No, it's not going to be. Look at verse 23 of that psalm. That's what 37 says. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Please, be good to somebody. The Lord will order your steps.
Amen.
Do not fall into evil.
Amen.
The erection that will kill somebody will become a blessing unto you. The poison that somebody will take that can kill them will become a fertilizer for you. The Lord will bless you.
Amen.
It's a good God. The Bible says, and he delights in his way. The Lord will delight in your way.
Amen.
In anything you lay your hands upon, over this man, in this year 2017, the Lord will have delight in it.
Amen.
And the Lord will help you.
Amen.
He will increase you.
Amen.
He will bless your labor, the labor of your hands.
Amen.
The Lord will grant you an opportunity to enjoy that labor.
Amen.
Do not fall into evil.
Amen.
The Almighty God will protect you.
Amen.
Do not fall into a sudden death.
Amen.
You know right now, the flu that you are all going around enjoying, some people are dying of flu. You not die suddenly.
Amen.
Where people go and they don't come back safely, you will go and come back safely.
Amen.
The business that you lay your hands upon, the Lord will cause you to examine it.
He's
a good God. He will be good to you.
Amen.
He will be good to you.
Amen.
He will keep you and guide you.
Amen.
He will bless you.
Amen.
He will cause his name to shine upon you.
Amen.
He will be gracious unto you.
Amen.
He will raise his countenance upon you.
Amen.
The Almighty God will grant you peace.
Amen.
Passes all over understanding shall be yours.
Amen.
Do not let anybody define you, how to live your life. I have determined that. This is a land of freedom. I will tell you again, every gate in this land, we are told to eat it together.
Amen.
And listen to me very carefully. You will prepare a table before me. In the presence of all those who don't want me to eat that cake. You will prepare that table before them, I will eat that cake.
Amen.
I will eat that cake. You will be annoyed. You will say, this cake you are eating is too much. Go back to that place where you came from. I will tell them, this cake, I will eat it. Because the God has prepared this cake before me. You have decided to be my enemies. And then all of you will be looking at me as I'm enjoying the cake. And only God determines the final word.
Absolutely.
You cannot, because you are a human being.
Absolutely.
You cannot determine the final word. The Almighty God who rules determine the final word. And when Jesus come home, I'm not going anywhere. When I talk home, I have one home. Heaven is my heaven. I don't know about you. Anywhere you come home is temporary. And when I finish here, I will also go and live with Christ in glory. I don't know about you. What about you? When I finish this place and I enjoy it with His peace and with all that He has given me, I will also go there and enjoy there. And that so shall truly be for you also.
Amen.
You live your life fully.
Amen.
Long life, goodness, the Lord shall grant you.
Amen.
Every blessing He has given you, the Lord will grant you the peace to enjoy that blessing.
Amen.
Don't live your life in sorrow.
Amen.
You don't weep over all that God has given you.
Amen.
Father, we thank you, bless you today, we worship you. Thank you for this wonderful time you have given us to come together as your children. As we have had your word, that you continue to help us out, God. To live according to your word that has come to us.
Amen.
To live according to the scriptures, the Bible that you have given us,
Amen.
The word of life. Blessed be your name, O God, forever. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.